So kinetics, moving or velocity. So chemical kinetics explain mainly the rate of reaction, mechanism of reaction, and followed by which factors affecting on rate of reaction. These all can be explained chemical kinetics. Okay, what is called rate? What are we given? The change in concentration of the reactants or products. Otherwise, I have given, if you can take any chemical reaction, so when the reaction starts, the reactant's concentrations are decreased. At the same time, product's concentrations are increased. The decreasing in concentration of the reactant or increase in concentration of the product for unit time, that is called rate of reaction. So one unit time, what is the change in concentration of the reactant? Otherwise, what is the change in concentration of the product? Is called rate of reaction. After that, based on time, reactions are classified into three types: very fast reactions, moderate reactions, slow reactions. Okay, very fast. The reactions takes place fraction of seconds. Which chemical reactions are takes place fraction of seconds? That is called very fast reactions. Examples: acid base reactions are fast reactions. So precipitation formation reactions also fast. These are takes within fraction of seconds are called fast reactions. Then moderate reactions. What are moderate reactions? Which can take minutes or hours. Which reactions for complexion takes minutes or hours? That is called moderate. So most of the chemical reactions are moderate. We get alcohols and acids. Alcohols and acids. That is a moderate reaction. Otherwise, sucrose hydrolysis. That is also moderate reaction. Okay, finally, slow reactions. So slow reaction means which can take maybe days or months. So that is called slow reaction. For example, if we can take rusting of iron, iron rust, it can take more days. So the type of reactions are called what we can say very slow reactions. Based on type, the reactions are classified as a three types: fast, moderate, slow. If the reaction takes fraction of seconds, fast. It can take minutes or hours, moderate. If days or years, whatever that is called slow. So after that, I have given what is called rate. So rate means the change in concentration of the reactants or products. The change in concentration, generally the decreasing in concentration of the reactant, or the increase in concentration of the product. For that, how much time taken? Required time. So for which purpose? Change in concentration. Change in concentration of the reactants or products. That is for rate. Okay, here. What is the unit of rate? Change in concentration. Concentration unit generally mole per liter. Mole into liter inverse. Mole per liter. For example, molarity. Number of moles of solute in 1 liter volume of solution, mole per liter. That is nothing but mole per decimeter cube. Mole per decimeter cube upon time taken. What about that? Seconds. So therefore, that equals to what we can say: mole, liter inverse, second inverse. Otherwise, it is nothing but what we can say: time inverse. Right? Time is recorded as a year, second inverse. So after that, average rate of reaction. What is called average rate of reaction? Say. Average rate of reaction. So, average rate of reaction means the change in concentration. What I have given? The change in concentration of the reactant or product. Divided by what you can take? Change in time. So the change in concentration of the reactant or product upon change in time. That is called average rate of reaction. Generally, average rate of reaction. How to represent? For example, say if I have given one equation, N2 plus 3H2 gives rise to 2NH3. So the preparation of ammonia reaction, whatever. For this reaction, how to write average rate of reaction? Average rate of reaction means with respect to reactants, negative side indicate decreasing concentration, positive side indicate increasing concentration. How to we can write that is minus. With respect to reactant, generally any chemical reaction, the reactants are disintegrating. Disintegration means the concentrations are decreased. disappearance, that is also called. If we can take the rate of disappearance of N2, that we can say minus, what we can take? Delta N2 concentration upon delta T time. Change in time. Change in concentration of the reactant N2. So reactant's concentration initially, what about that? Decrease. Because of that reason, I have taken negative sign. Okay, say what is the rate of disappearance of reactant H2? Minus 1 by 3. Delta H2 concentration by delta T. Okay, for example, product, the rate of appearance. Appearance means formation, form. Reactants are consumed. Finally, to form a products. The rate of appearance, that is equals to with respect to product. What about that? Plus 1 by 2. Delta N is 3 upon delta T. Here finally, so these all are generally minus delta N2 concentration upon delta T equals to minus 1 by 3 delta H2 concentration by delta T, that is equals to plus half, whatever the delta ammonia. Delta ammonia concentration upon delta T. It is called average rate of reaction. Now, suddenly, instantaneous rate of reaction. Instantaneous rate of reaction. Okay, see. Instantaneous rate of reaction means generally, the change in concentration of the reactant or product. The change in concentration of the either reactant or product at particular time interval, at a fixed time interval. At a particular time interval, what is the change of concentration of the reactant or product? That is called instantaneous reaction. Okay, for example, instantaneous reaction means if we can take, see this. So I have taken is a time. Time on x-axis is the increasing direction. It is a concentration of the reactants. Concentration of the reactants series. It is a time, it is a concentration of the reactants. Okay, when the reaction starts, initially the reactants concentrations are very high. Concentration means it is nothing but amount. Generally, if we can take any reaction, initially only reactant amounts is present. There is no product. What is the reaction starting product amount? Zero. So, before reaction, what is the amount of product? Zero. The amount is nothing but concentration. The amount is nothing but concentration. initially reactant concentrations are very high. When the reaction starts, if I have started the reaction, slowly this amount decreases. The reactant slowly consumed or converted as a product. So when this amount decreases, at the same time this amount will increase. Amount is nothing but concentration. So initially reactant concentrations are very high. When the reaction starts, this reactant concentration slowly decreases. At the same time, product concentration increases. Any chemical reaction like that only. Now here, see. It is the concentration of the reactants. So when the reaction starts, along with time, the concentration, what about the decrease? For example, if I have taken it is a time, it is a concentration of products. What about that? Here, what we are observing? So, increasing order. So, along with the time, the product's concentration sort of put the increases. Now, here, if the changing concentration we can take one particular time, for example, I have taken here. So, at this particular time, okay, T1 time. So, at particular time, the change in concentration, that is called instantaneous rate of reaction. At particular T1 time, I have taken one particular time that is referred as a T1. The change in concentration of the reactant, that is called instantaneous rate of reaction. Otherwise here, one particular time, that is referred as a T1. The change in concentration of the product, that is also referred as a instantaneous rate of reaction. Simply, at particular interval time, what is the change in concentration of the reactants or product? That is called instantaneous reaction. Average reaction, instantaneous reaction. Both are differable. So instead of delta, we can take small d, derivative. So, small dx by dt time. So, instead of delta, we can take derivative. That is only difference between average rate of reaction and instantaneous rate of reaction. So, small interval, derivatives, okay. For example, same this equation. If they ask, what is the instantaneous rate of reaction? What is the instantaneous rate of reaction? Say that instantaneous rate of reaction for this equation. So what we can take derivative, same like this only, minus with respect to reactant, here indirectly what about that? 1 by 1. So, dN2 concentration by dV. Otherwise, dN2 concentration by dV. That is equals to minus 1 by 3 dN2 H2 concentration by dt. That is equals to plus 1 by 2 dNS3 concentration by dt. Okay, we can take the derivatives. With respect to derivatives, that is called instantaneous rate of reaction at particular time interval. If we can take the rate of reaction, that is called instantaneous rate of reaction. Overall change, that is called average rate of reaction. Generally, the rate of reaction, it depends on mainly the concentration of the reactants and temperature and catalyst. Okay, now what is called rate law or rate of reaction? Rate law. See this, the important. Rate law. That is also nothing but rate of reaction. Rate of reaction. Okay, according to rate law, the rate of chemical reaction is always depends on the concentration of the reactants. Generally, the concentration of the reactants more, the rate also more. For example, say I have given A gives rise to B. Now for this reaction, the rate is directly proportional to the concentration of A. The concentration of reactant. For example, A plus B gives rise to C plus D. For this reaction, the rate is directly proportional to the product of concentrations of reactants. What about the product? A concentration into B concentration. That is called rate law. Therefore, rate equals to, say, what about the rate? K constant. Say, where K is. What about K? Rate constant. What you can say? Rate constant. Okay, rate equals to K into concentration of A. Here, rate equals to K concentration of A into concentration of B. This is called rate law, where K equals to rate constant. For example, say this equation, rate law. For this equation, rate law. Rate directly proportional to concentration of N2 into concentration of H2 here power, whole power 3. This is called rate of reaction. Rate equals to what we can take K into N2 concentration upon H2 concentration power 3. Okay, now is where K equals to rate constant. What is the unit of rate constant? Say, what is the unit of rate constant? What is called rate constant? See, if for example, you have taken if the concentration of A is 1 unit. Otherwise, yes. If the concentration of A and B is 1 unit, what we can take according to this? The rate equals to K. There also rate equals to K. If the concentrations of the reactants are 1 unit, in that case, the rate always equal to rate constant. Rate always equal to rate constant. Now, rate constant K equal to rate constant K equal to what we can take? Generally, rate constant K equal to what is the unit here? For example, say this equation. For this equation, what is the unit? K equals to rate upon concentration of A. Okay, here we know rate units. Rate unit, what about that? Rate unit mole into liter inverse time inverse. Time inverse. Okay, here concentration of A. Concentration unit. What about that? Mole per liter. See, if I have taken rate, that is equals to K into concentration of A power N. N moles of A I have taken to form D. Okay, here N moles of D, whatever. For this reaction, rate equals to, generally, what we can take, rate is directly proportional to the concentration of A power N. Therefore, rate equals to K into A power N. Therefore, K equals to rate upon A concentration power N. Now, say, what are the units we have? Okay, rate unit mole liter inverse, mole per liter upon what I have taken, time inverse. Generally, rate means so concentration upon time. Rate is nothing but change in concentration upon time. Concentration unit, what about the mole liter inverse? It is a time. That's why I have taken mole into liter inverse into time inverse. Understood? Rate, change in concentration upon time. Concentration means mole per liter. Mole into liter inverse. time t. So therefore, mole later inverse time inverse upon what about that concentration power n? Concentration power n means what about the concentration unit? Mole per liter. Then let's see. Mole liter inverse power n. Right? That is nothing but k. Mole liter inverse time inverse upon mole power n. It is what about that minus k, right? Or say that finally what we get? Mole 1 minus n. Mole 1 minus n into next liter n minus 1. N minus 1 is a minus. We get the plus. So after that, what about the time inverse? Remaining time inverse. So based on this formula, we say any type of reaction is given. What is the rate constant units? Rate constant units. Right? Now, the rate constant, it is different for different reactions. Reaction to reaction, rate constant will change. Generally, rate constant is higher. Rate constant K value is more. The rate of reaction is also more. Rate constant value low. The rate of reaction is also low. Rate constant more, rate of reaction more. Rate constant low, rate of reaction also low. Generally, at constant temperature, at constant temperature, the rate constant is also, the K value is also constant for given equation. Given reaction, constant temperature is given. The K value is also constant. There is no change. These are the rate constant K. Right? Okay, write on this unit conversion. Example this equation. Thank you.
Thank you.